I'm gonna tell y'all that story at the end if we got time. I'm gonna tell y'all. All right, so when you say times have changed, one of the things that's changed nowadays, we got shit like school shootings and shit. That's crazy, right? Yeah. But I'm gonna say this, every time I hear about a school shooting, I automatically know it's a white school. Because white schools have school shootings, but black schools have shootouts. somebody's shooting back in this motherfucker at the black school. The principal got a gun, the janitor, somebody in this bitch is shooting back in this motherfucker. Daquan, whoever the fuck is better than Aisha Pussy, he's shooting somebody. Another way we know times have changed now is you got people, and looks like some of y'all probably have done this. I found that one of my homies spent $200 to put his son in swim school. Let me fill y'all in. Did y'all know that all of us naturally know how to swim? Let me tell y'all this. Let me tell you how my daddy taught me how to swim. He put me in a hot tub for about 15 minutes, walked away, snuck up behind my big ass and threw me in the deep end of the pool. When that cold water hit my body, I went into shock. Not only did I learn how to swim, I learned how to make a quiche. I learned trigonometry. I came up speaking Spanish with a bachelor's degree. Fuck y'all. That's the first time I realized I was a flotation device. You know what I'm saying? Okay, right over the top. Bloop, bloop. It worked right on. Don't spend no money on no damn swim school. Another way times have changed is this social media shit, right? Everybody got Facebook and Instagrams and all that shit, right? But now what we got on Facebook is everybody got this Facebook beef. Everybody talking shit about each other, right? Y'all hit to that shit? So let me tell y'all. So I had some Facebook beef. All right. So the other day, somebody just went on Facebook and was talking shit like, yo, when I see your fat ass, I'm gonna fuck you up. Next time I see you, I'm gonna knock you out. I just deleted it because I thought that was rude. You know, I'm trying to be a gentleman, move on. Next thing you know, they hit it again. Next time I see your fat ass, I'm gonna fuck you up. And I ain't gonna lie, y'all, I feel like there's no way for a mother to talk to her son. she tagging my aunts like, I told you the nigga wasn't no good. I'm gonna tell him that the mailman is his daddy in the minute and shit. I'm replying like, hashtag inbox, mama, inbox. That's some bullshit. Are you posting this? She tagging my friends, I'm gonna beat his ass when he come home. I'm like, y'all, I gotta move out. I done ate my mama's chicken. And she... I'm 47 years old, getting whoopings and shit. My friends walking me home and shit, you know what I mean? This is bad. Move out your mama's house. Something else that's different now with this social media shit, right, is this Instagram, right? I met this chick on Instagram. Let me tell you about this shit. I wish this was a joke. This is true shit. So I met this chick on Instagram. She's a little younger than me. She tell me, all right, come over. We about to get it in. Happy old traveling comedian. Appreciates a little strange interaction every now. You understand what I mean there, Gilligan? My dude, all right. My man. So I'm getting ready to go over there. And she posted a picture on Instagram of her sitting in this dirty ass bedroom talking about where the party at. I look behind her, I said, shit, the party look like it's behind you. Look like you're having a prom for rats and roaches in this motherfucker. Look, you got DJ Ebola on the ones and twos. Coronavirus sitting in VIP popping bottles in this motherfucker. Her bed looks so dirty, it looked like a homeless man grew up on that motherfucker. But I'm a man, I just want to say, I'm making a fuck, I'm on the way. Catch an Uber, I get the Uber over there, the Uber doesn't even want to pull in the driveway because he said the driveway had an STD. I said, oh shit. I'm walking along the driveway trying not to get herpes or will I am, black eyed peas. If it's a peas, I didn't want the shit. Get to the front door, knock on the door was dusty, that should have been a clue. She let me in, I walk in, the carpet is crunchy and shit. It's mold on the walls. I told her I had to use the bathroom. I'm in the bathroom. Apparently the toilet was broke, so I peed in the tub like everybody else. Shit, I Then I come out and sit down on this grassy ass couch she got and shit. How you mow a couch? I ain't trying to figure that shit out. And I'm trying to get it in. We get it in on that crunchy ass carpet. I'm fucking shattered on that crunchy ass carpet. That's what I'm talking about. But here's the problem. When she sat up, y'all, her wig was still stuck to the carpet. Yeah. Till you dated a woman with a wig, you don't know how big the head is. So you see what happened. Her head was so big that she had an idea or a thought it wouldn't get here till tomorrow. She was big as fuck. She sat up bald head. I thought I just fucked one of my homeboys. I didn't know. And then she cuts on the light, right? And it looked like a scene from the movie 300 broke out on the floor. Bed bugs versus the roaches. The bed bugs started to advance, but the roaches jumped on their back and rode the motherfuckers to victory. It was epic. It was epic. But I'm a man, I didn't give a shit. I just wanted some muscle. We go upstairs, you know what I'm saying? We gonna go upstairs so we can get away from the scene of the movie and shit. We sit down on the homeless bed. She rolled up some weed. We about to hit this weed. We watching this porno, right?
Woo!
You know, oh, you, were you there? My girl. Later. I got you. Not that I have any officer. This dude right there looked like he's been arrested. 40 motherfuckers looked just like me yesterday. There's a Cletus in this motherfucker somewhere. I don't know. There is a Cletus. So she rolled his weed up, right? In the scene in this porno, there's a dude that does a 360-degree spin while he's still in the ass. She hit that weed like, Big Daddy, I want you to do that. I was like, I got you, boo. So I go to get ready to do this spin. Spun my ass right off the bed, into the corner, fucked up the nightstand, the lamp, drywall. This is a neighbor man, the motherfucker. Now I gotta figure out how I'm gonna claim a dick armpit injury from Aflac and shit. My dick was all in my... Now I gotta go explain to my wife why my dick smell like speed stick. This is bad. This is bad. But I'm a G, I told you I'm a fat lead. I'm about my shit, so I hop right back at it, right? I'm engine, but I'm right behind her doing my thing. Now these young girls, man, they athletic as fuck. She was doing jumping jacks while giving the niggas some head. I was like, shit, if you don't sit your ass. She like, come on, go faster, daddy, go faster. I'm like, hey, don't fuck with my discount. Damn it, you see the gray hair? Shit. But here's what's even more crazy, right? So I'm behind her, I'm doing my thing. I smack her on the ass one good time because my blue pill was working good. I had my shit. You know, I wore this in honor of that. Don't think of the color. This means something. Fuck y'all. I got a sponsorship on them motherfuckers. But I'm behind her smacking her ass. I'm like, who's your daddy? Next thing I know, I feel somebody smack me on my ass like, is you my daddy? Her daughter was in the room the whole goddamn time.
Oh my God.
Her daughter was in the room the whole time and shit. She run down the hall to get her little brothers and sisters like, hey y'all, I'm daddy here. And I hear pitter-patter of feet running down the hall. Hey y'all, the fat lead came in handy. I dove out that pussy right into the closet and shit. I did a tuck and roll. Fuck y'all. Now, y'all want to hear something that's even more fucked up? It was another dude already in the closet. Ain't that a bitch? Tuck and roll out there, dude. Oh, shit. I ain't doing it. So, yeah, man, this shit's crazy. A lot of this social media shit got everything so fake nowadays. Like, round of applause if you got real eyelashes.
Yeah!
Oh, okay. Some of y'all lying, that's cool, though. hey, this eyelash shit done got too out of hand. Like, in a minute, they finna have pilot licenses with these eyelashes. You motherfuckers is finna take flight on a windy day. I dated a chick one time, we had to hold her ass down like a float at the parade. Bitch, if you don't get your ass, she's sitting at the dinner table hovering and shit, just because y'all don't, ladies, stop with that shit, please. Y'all scaring the fuck out of me, okay? Plus, y'all know the eyelashes made in China, so you can go ahead and put that coronavirus on your shit if you wanna. You know, now, I'm gonna say this real quick, and it's probably in the room for it, but I don't give a shit. Are y'all really buying into this coronavirus shit? I'm just, get out of here. You don't think they would name a virus after a beer? Real talk? Get the fuck out of here. Alright. They say coronavirus killing everybody, but we done lost more people from the flu this year than we have coronavirus.
Yep.
I'm gonna say this. I done lost more black friends to the police than coronavirus. Fuck coronavirus, but we have Tyronavirus in this motherfucker. Just shit. Then we get back. Oh man. So real talk, another way times have changed now is I got a homie that's a fucking stalker. Andy Black. That's crazy, like. So part of being a stalker means you gotta be quiet at all times. Real good black qualities, you know what I'm talking about? It's a black dude on the way to this show right now. He's still outside parking the car. He laying in the way, trust me. Yeah, well, homie, that's a stalker though, y'all. And here's the crazy part about what he's doing. He's unemployed. He's paying his friends to drop him off at a bush so he can stalk them up. The first question I had is she a recruiter? Does she work for a temp service? Won't you stalk an application, motherfucker? Why don't you stalk somebody in HR, nigga? What is that? And on top of that, he a big dude that looks kind of like me, right? So imagine my big ass hiding behind a bush. The bush gonna hide behind me. What the fuck is y'all talking about? This, I know I wouldn't be no good stalker because I'm gonna fuck around, get bored, and smoke a joint in the bush. And then after I smoke, I'm gonna get the munchies, I'm gonna order a pizza to the bush. And I'm black when I get done eating, what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go to sleep in the bush. This is, you know, it's not gonna be a good stalker shit. It's not gonna work for me. You know, you all right? I want to tell y'all something that happened yesterday. We had a lady sit right here through three comedians, didn't laugh once. She was evil as fuck. It turned out, y'all, that she had just had some cabbage and she was in there fucking that bathroom up. She was, I wish she was here. I'm gonna roast the shit out of her. Her evil ass. Don't be mad at us because you got bad dietary shit. She up here really wanting to fart like a motherfucker, but she ain't gonna do shit. I fucked with her for like 10 minutes, y'all. I ain't gonna walked her to the bathroom, to the car. But she smelled like privacy. She smelled like she wanted to be alone. I'm like, privacy. I'm her privacy.